Hey everybody, how you doing today? Just doing a fairly quick video on my knife collecting. At this point in my collection, I made a decision on where I want to take my knife collecting from here on out. What you see before you is a pretty much general representation of what I started out with to what I'm collecting now, sort of thing. This is the actual knife, my first actual knife that I ever had. Had this when I was 8 years old. You can see in its fair bit of use. I'm not sure of the make of it, but it's definitely a tiny little knife. That's what started off my knife collecting. From there, very soon after, I started to get into other sort of blades, ones with locks. This little lock back here, it's a colonial. See if I could get a sort of close up of that. Good solid little knife. I think I had that when I was 10. From there I got into what I call corner store knives in Canada, at least where I live. You could get knives from your local corner store, mainly ones that are like this. This is a M-Tech. You find these a lot, made in China. Some of them are half decent, some of them aren't. This one's sort of good. It's no blade play, the lockup's good, sort of design overall is nice. I started getting into these sort of knives when I was about 13 to about 16 or 17, when I was able to actually go and buy my own knives, when my parents would let me go and with them buy a knife. They got me, or my dad got me, this buck knife when I was about 13 or 14, and this is what really set me off for wanting to get more knives. Just the overall usage I got out of this showed what a knife can do through a day-to-day process. And Buck to this day, Buck knives are still one of my favorite brands as a user knife. You can see this one here. The Buck 110 is probably a staple in any collection. Just a classic design, the actual jackknife type, and very solid knife, this one here. From there, I sort of wanted to get into a little bit better knife in general, not these ones you can find pretty much anywhere. So that around that time, around I'd say maybe 18 to 19, I started getting into a little bit of YouTube videos, but not too much. Then the sort of hobby died out for about 4 or 5 years. I was still interested in knives. I still carried one, but I didn't really go and buy any. I didn't really search out any. Cut to maybe when I was 26 to maybe 28 years old, and stumble across a YouTube video on this knife here, actually, the Spyderco Tenacious. It was a test video of it, and that sort of rekindled my interest in sort of getting a better quality overall knife. And through my YouTube searches and looking at plenty of videos around the age of 30, the age I am now, I started really getting sort of more serious about my knife collecting. Since the year and a half, almost going on a year and a half of being on YouTube and looking through videos on YouTube and actually having my own channel, I've seen my knife collection step up from what you see here to these other two rows. And without that, I don't think I would have even known of any of these brands, because where I live, none of these are carried in stores. We don't have Kershaw's in our Walmarts or Canadian Tires. I guess you guys don't have Canadian Tire in the States. Maybe you do, I'm not too sure. But we don't carry these sort of knives here in our department stores. So just getting online and seeing these, I sort of wanted to pick one up. I ended up going with this one here as one of my first actual sort of name brand knives. It's the Kershaw Oh So Sweet. It's speed safe. It was my first jump into sort of the knife culture, let's say. And from there, I went through a couple different models of Kershaw's, sort of model of CRKT. This is the small Ken Onion Ripple. Just sort of getting into the overall better quality than your department store brand or your no-name sort of Chinese brand like these two up here. From there, I decided I wanted to sort of dip my toe a little further into the knife world and see what a maybe US-made knife from a production company gave me. I went with these two here, and the Kershaw Leeks and the Scallion. This is the Kershaw Zing. This was discontinued a while back. This is made in the US, real G10. Funky sort of blade to it with those ray patterns on it. And that's actually milled into the blade. You could actually hear that. But a really awesome flipper, a really awesome design with those sort of angled thumb studs there. Flies out with those thumb studs. And from this knife and the Kershaw Leek here, I really, really wanted to start looking for that overall, what a lot of people call that best knife, what's the best knife out there sort of thing. The best knife out there is sort of what you use your knives for, so it's a very personal thing. The best knife for me would be either a small fixed blade like you see here, or a larger folder like you see here. I do enjoy all these knives, even smaller ones, such as this one here. I do carry this from time to time, and actually do use it when I do carry it. All my knives are pretty much tools, some more than others. Just for example, I really don't consider my BK-17 a part of my overall collection. It's more of a tool than a part of the collection, whereas maybe this here is more a part of my collection than a tool, if that makes actually any sense. But from this sort of budget, but still good quality user knives, I sort of moved to a little bit higher quality, a little bit higher end, more expensive basically, but you get a little bit better quality. You get better steels, better heat treats, better overall quality insurance. Just going through these, this is the Spyderco Tenacious. This is what really started me off in looking for quality blades. Quality meaning something that you may pay a little bit more for, but you'll get a lot more quality than, let's say, these. Let's say that's $27. This is about $36 to $40, and the quality is 100% better in this one than in those. Just like moving on to the Spyderco Mannix, the quality of this knife, in my opinion, is 10 times better than the quality of that knife. Even though this knife is great, and I really love using it, the overall quality and build of this knife is better. You got to be careful sometimes when you're looking at knives because not necessarily the more price, the better quality. Looking at maybe a Topps knife. Topps knives are very quality blades. Their fit and finish is pretty much second to none, with the overall appearance being quite awesome. You see that micarta there, that pattern. But some people, and me included, say that a lot of their blades are overpriced for what you get, meaning micarta, 1095 steel, the heat treat, the coating, doesn't sort of add up to the almost $70 that this knife cost. Whereas, sorry about that guys, my camera battery died. Like I was saying, for the price and what you get with this knife, the $70 is would be a little bit overpriced. Compare that to maybe the Spyderco Manix, the maybe $99 with tax and shipping that it cost me, with what you get with this, the S30V blade, the very, very smooth action. It's a very, very smooth knife. I don't really like doing that, but just to prove my point. For the $90 you'd spend on this versus the $70 you'd spend on this, you could argue a lot of different points on what makes each knife cost that much, but for the value for me, this would be a better value than this. Now, if I'm using a knife outdoors, this one would be the better value because I would want the best quality tool for the job. For EDC and collecting, getting back on track to what I wanted to sort of make this video about, where I wanted to take my collection. For me, my money's better spent on something that's maybe a little bit more expensive, but I want that quality. So I won't mind paying the $100 for a Manix. In fact, I paid it twice. And I wouldn't mind paying it again because the quality's there for the price. I struggle to buy myself another Topps knife because it's 1095 steel. It's a really good steel, don't get me wrong. Second to none in my opinion, out in the bush. And it's basically how much you're willing to pay for what sort of quality. Basically any knife here will do the same job. It's whether how long that steel will last for and how long the overall knife will last for. There goes with more on the lines of where I want to spend my money. I don't want to see a knife that I spend $100 go to crap in a year, so I'd want that better quality, that better build. I'm finding myself having an easier time spending more money on fixed blades than folders. I see fixed blades lasting a heck of a lot longer than even the best folding knife, taking care of each respectively. There's just a lot less that could go wrong with a fixed blade. Take this, in fact, it's almost, I spent almost $190 tax and everything, and had a very easy time forking over the cash for it. Whereas maybe something like this, I had a hard time purchasing just because of the price and a lot of variables. Having it now, it's totally worth the money. I just got this recently, and it's sort of a point of my collecting that I sort of started with collecting by locks, so liner locks, back locks, slip joints, that sort of thing. But now I see myself sort of collecting by blade steel. So I think I'm gonna continue along that vein of collecting. The reason I'm doing this video is I have a knife on the way. It's sort of the pinnacle or the peak of all these knives. It's a I don't want to give too much away because I don't know when I'll be receiving that knife. It's a custom knife, let's just say, and I'm super excited about it. It's just interesting to me to see the overall evolution of my knife collecting since basically being on YouTube and the information it's provided me. I could honestly say without the research and the videos that are out there, I would have never have found out about most of these brands. in the future, I could say right now that I will be collecting more Spyderco knives. To me, they're really good value for what you get. I'm just starting out getting used to VG10. Like I said, I only had this Spyderco Delica now for about 3 days, and so far really liking it. I touched the blade up just a little bit, just a light stropping with it, and it's very, very sharp now, and the action on it's smoothed up, and the blade play and the lockup is still perfect. There is no blade play either direction, up and down, side to side, and yeah, so you could see further videos from me. The knives will be more of this variety here, and I still love these sort of knives here. The knives you could pay maybe $30 to $50 and still get quality knives for that price. But my collecting lies within maybe here for the future on out. I see a lot more fixed blades, me purchasing them, and I see a lot more Spyderco knives. I've been looking at zero tolerance recently as a possibility to buy, but we'll see, right? Thanks for listening to me ramble through this video, and stay tuned, guys. I got some things planned for the future. Take care, guys, and as always, thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, and comment below, and take care, guys. Thanks.